Hi, I'm Keith from the Bada team of Samsung Mobile. In this video, we're going to look at some of Bada's powerful multimedia features. We'll walk you step by step through a sample application which can record and playback video, and along the way, we'll introduce you to some tips and techniques that you can make use of in your own applications. This video should help you get up to speed with Bada development. Make sure you check out our blog at developer.bada.com and keep an eye out for the rest of our developer videos on YouTube. We're going to build a simple video recorder and player that shows how to record video using the camera and play back the file we've recorded. We'll be using the camera class to do the recording and playing back the video using the player class. This UML diagram shows the relationship between these classes. The player class provides the ability to play both audio and video content, either stored locally or streamed from a remote server. It is possible to create multiple instances of the player class. Up to 10 can exist at a time. The camera class provides several methods for controlling the device's cameras. The supported properties are device dependent, and the available list can be retrieved using the methods of the camera and media capability classes. The video recorder class provides video recording from the camera device. The supported codecs and resolutions are device dependent, and the available list can be retrieved using the methods available in this class. The recording operation is limited by the maximum time or the maximum size. Here's a simple video form that we'll create. The form will contain two overlay regions to control video recording and playback. Here's where we'll place the overlay region used for video. And here is where we will place the one for playback. Understanding the role of the overlay region is very important when implementing video in Bada. An overlay region consists of a foreground layer and a background buffer which supports hardware-accelerated rendering of video. Here's how we define our two overlay region objects. To use an overlay region, we must first validate the size and position of the region we want to create. To do this, we call the evaluate bounds method, passing a bounds evaluation option, the requested rectangle, and a boolean which the API can update. If the evaluate bounds returns true, the overlay region is suitable for us to use. We then call the getOverlayRegionN method to get a handle to the overlay region. Here we specify what the overlay region is to be used for, along with a rectangle object which describes the position and size of the region. Note that the evaluate bounds could update the rectangle we passed in, and in this case, the modified boolean would be set to true. It is worth checking this as the position and size of your overlay region may not be to your liking. For playing back the recorded video content, we need to create a playback overlay region. This pretty much follows the scheme for the record region, but in the getOverlayRegionN method, we pass overlay region type normal. We need to set up the background buffers for each overlay region to use for recording and playback. Now we've built our user interface, it's time to write the code to record video. First, we need to construct a camera object. Next, we create a video recorder object and construct it by passing our camera object as a parameter. Once we've created our video recorder object, we need to do some configuration. The video recorder class contains methods that allow us to set the video quality to record at, whether to record video as well as audio, also the video format such as 3GP or MP4, and also how long to record for. As a final piece of the setup, we use the createVideoFile method to specify the path of the file used to store our recorded video. Before we can record video, we have to start the camera preview. With the camera started, we get the preview resolution. This is independent of the dimensions of the overlay panel into which it is rendered. We use the preview resolution to set the recording resolution of the video recorder object. It's very important that we set this value correctly. Now we can start to record. The user clicks the record button, and from within our onActionPerformed method, we call the record method of the video recorder object. If the video recorder is closed, you need to open it again by calling createVideoFile. This sets up the video recorder object for a new recording. When the user clicks the stop button, we need to take a couple of steps to stop the recording. We check the state of the video recorder to ensure that it's actually recording, and then call the stop method. We then close the file we recorded to by calling the close method. We can stop the camera preview at this point, although in our example, we keep the preview going. Let's have a look at our project in action. So far, we've implemented the code to preview and record video. Next, we'll show you how to implement video playback. A player object is required to play back audio or video. In the case of video, the player object needs a background buffer which we've obtained from the overlay panel used to render the video. Once our player object is constructed, we call OpenFile, passing the path of the file to play. Then we call the play method to start the video playing. Before stopping playback, we should check the state of the player, then close the file. Let's see what our project looks like now that we've added the playback code. Hello, so let's start recording. So what we're doing now, we're recording from the first live camera preview and we're recording to a file within the file system. So now what we should do is stop our recording and have a look at what it looks like when we play it back. So now let's have a look below at our recorded file. So what we're doing now, we're recording from the first live camera preview and we're recording...
I think that's a job well done. Shall we get off now?
Yeah, let's go.
So now, what we should do is stop our recording. In this video, we showed you how to implement playing and recording video in Bada. We explained the role of the video recorder, camera and player classes and showed you how to use overlay regions for live previews and video playback. Keep checking our websites for recipes, technical notes and sample code used in this video. Thanks for watching.